Shalom, my beautiful sisters and brothers, kings and queens in Christ. God bless you. If you are new here, my name is Crystal. So glad to have you here. Today, I will be doing a devotional and we will be in Hebrews chapter 11, verse 8 through 16. Yes, Hebrews 11, verse 8 through 16. We will be talking about strangers and foreigners. If this is something that you would like to listen to and watch, please continue. Okay, my brothers and sisters, we are in Hebrews chapter 11, verse 8 through 16, and it reads, "By faith, Abraham, when called to go to a place he would later receive as an inheritance, obeyed and went even though he did not know where he was going. By faith, he made his home in the promised land like a stranger in a foreign country."
My brothers and sisters, he lived in tents, as did Isaac and Jacob, who were heirs with him of the same promise. For he was looking forward to the city with foundations, whose architect and builder is God. And by faith, even Sarah, who was past childbearing age, was enabled to bear children because she considered him faithful, who had made the promise. And so from this one man, and he as good as dead, came descendants, a numerous as the stars in the sky, and the countless as the sand on the seashore.
My brothers and sisters, it says all these people were still living by faith when they died. They did not receive the things promised. They only saw them and welcomed them from a distance, admitting that they were foreigners and strangers on earth. Glory, hallelujah, Jesus. People who say such things show that they are looking for a country of their own. If they had been thinking of the country they had left, they would have had an opportunity to return. Instead, they were longing for a better country, a heavenly one. Therefore, God is not ashamed to be called their God, for he has prepared a city for them. Glory, hallelujah. And that city is called heaven. My brothers and sisters, that city is called heaven. This land, this world that we live in, this universe, this is not our home. You think you the only one that is going through things out in life? You think you the only one who is trying to sow seeds to bear fruit and you don't see it just as yet? Keep faith. Don't give up, because that's what the enemy wants you to do. That's what the enemy wants you to believe. Don't keep your eyes on what somebody else doing. Keep your eyes on the Lord. Amen. My brothers and sisters, it said Abraham's life was filled with faith. As God commanded, he left home and went to another land. Why? Because he was obeying without questioning. Stop questioning God and do as God say. Open your ears so you can hear and you can believe. Abraham believed. He believed the covenant that God made with him. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Many of us, brothers and sisters, we get frustrated and defeated because our needs and wants and expectations and demands are not immediately met when they believe in Christ. You got to believe in Jesus Christ and have faith. That's where your faith come in at. Be patient. Don't quit. Don't give up. Don't be discouraged. Your achievement and your goal seems may seem far away, but God sees everything. Nothing you do is useless. Amen. Nothing you do. Take courage. Take courage in the people that were before us, our ancestors. Amen. Our ancestors, they paved the way for us. They didn't give up. They were some faith pushers. You hear me? They were some faith pushers and they were strong. You wonder where you get your strongness from, your boldness from, your encouragement, your motivation. You getting it from your ancestors passed on to you. Glory, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Come through, Holy Spirit. Come through, Holy Spirit. Come through, Holy Spirit. You saying, why me? Why not me? Why? Think about the people before you that didn't get to see their fruits of their faith on earth. But yet, what did they do? They continued to believe in Jesus Christ. Don't give up, my brothers and sisters. Don't give up. Amen. So now we are going to go into the worksheet portion. And it says, identify a way God is growing your faith. Identify a way God is growing your faith. Even though you may not see the future, what God has for you, I'm here to tell you, continue to praise and worship his name no matter what. You will become a faith pusher. Do you understand what I'm saying?
I'm proud to say that I am truly with the JC. I am truly with the JC, Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. Thank you, Father God. So now we are going to go to the connect area, and it says, describe a time when you moved to a different town or were new to a team or club or activity. What was it like to be an outsider? And when I read this, you guys, I was like, Holy Spirit, come through. You is talking to me, Father God. You is giving me confirmation. So actually, I do live in a different town, you guys. And I've been here going on almost 3 years. And we were outsiders when we moved here. Amen. So when we moved here, kids used to pick with my children. They threw things at my apartment. Y'all don't know this because y'all just not hearing today. They threw things at my apartment. They even was trying to break into one of my windows in my kitchen. But as time progressed, I prayed and prayed and prayed. They noticed that we was here for the time being. You can't run nobody off. God will use people in extraordinary ways, and Satan will do the same thing. Amen. So you have to realize you got to get yourself together in a godly manner. Amen. So you will be able to handle these outsiders. Amen. You got to be able to pray and have strength for Father God. Glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Because the enemies are not going to get old. They are going to get newer. They are going to get stronger. But guess what? They have no mighty power greater than the Lord Jesus Christ above. He is ordained over all things. All things. You hear me? All things. You put your faith in God and God will direct you. You just believe and have faith and you stay strong in the word of God, and God will show you the wisdom, the knowledge, and the guidance. Glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Come through, Lord. Come through. Come through this morning. Come through this morning, Holy Spirit. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 10. It says, he was looking forward to the city with foundations whose architect and builders is God. No matter where you move, when God say move, move, okay? I'm not saying when God say don't move. When God say move, move, I done moved plenty of times. And when God tell me to move, baby, I'm moving. I don't care if I move dang on 10 times out of a month. When God say move, Krista, pack you and your family stuff up. It's time to go, sister. It's time to go, my child. Let's get it. I'm out of here. I'm packing everything up. Better hope I don't leave everything and start fresh, because sometimes God say leave that stuff where it's at. Leave it where it said and move on. I got greater for you, my child. Amen. So now we are at the inventory. So now we are in the take inventory of the worksheet, and it reads, as a follower of Jesus, heaven, not earth, is your true home, my brothers and sisters. What is exciting about heaven being your real home? And this is where you're going to write and list those things that I'm going to keep that part private to me, because glory be to God. God knows. I know, my brothers and sisters, this place where we live at, this is not our home. This is not our home. And when God called me home and get ready to take me to heaven, glory to God, I'm going to be ready. I'm going to be ready. Baby, you better listen to Yolanda Adams. You better get yourself ready. You better get yourself ready with the Lord. Amen. So with that being said, peace and blessings to you all. May you all have a prosperous and blissful day. Glory. Hallelujah. God is good. Thank you, Jesus. With that being said, shalom. Until next time.